What's up? David Morgan here, checking out Kendrick Lamar's fifth album called Mr. Morale and the Big Steppers. Welcome to the reaction series. We're doing seven different songs off of his latest album today. The second song is called, that I'm checking out, is N95. So let's get right into it. Don't forget to like, subscribe, hit the bell icon, and leave some comments for me. I'm digging what I'm hearing so far. There's a journey we're going on. The first song had a lot of movement in it and a lot of different movements, different parts, different sections. And really digging it. So let's go. This one's called N95. Howie?
Hello, new world, all the boys and girls. I got some true stories to tell. You're back outside, but they still lied. Whoa. Yeah.
Take off the foo-foo. Take off the cloud chase. Take off the Wi-Fi. Take off the money phone. Take off the car loan. Take off the flex and the white loss. Take off the weird-ass jewelry. I'ma take 10 steps, then I'm taking off top off. Take off some fabricated dreams and the microwave memes. It's a real world outside. Take off your idols. Take off the runway. Take off the Cairo. Take off the Sandro Pay. 5 days stay. Take off for the meal. Hella final. Take off the far flare. Take off perception. Take off the cop with the iPad. Take off the allure. Take off the unsure. Take off decisions I lack.
Okay, so I'm getting to hear that the N95 has to do, obviously, with a mask, but what all the other masks that we wear, all the bullshit, all the facades that we walk around in the world with, God, it's so tiring, isn't it? Like to be a part of that and to watch it or to do it yourself. Like it takes a lot of energy to not be you, to be someone different than who you really are. Take off the fake deep, take off the fake woke. So he's just going off on facade-ism, being fake and phony. But I'll tell you something. I think most fakeness and phoniness, people don't even understand that they're being that way. They're so used to being fake and phony that they can't help it. You know what I'm saying? It's kind of sad.
Take off the fake deep, take off the fake woke, take off the I'm broke, cock here. Take off the gossip, take off the new logic, that if I'm rich, I'm real. Take off the should know, take off the doje, take off the broken bag. Take all that designer bullshit off, and what do you have?
Bitch! You ugly as fuck!
You out of pocket.
Two ATMs, you step in the what?
You out of pocket.
Who you think they talk about? Talk about us!
You out of pocket.
Who you think they copy up? Copy up us!
Get back in pocket.
The world in a panic, the women is stranded, the men on the run. The profits are vanished, the law take advantage, the market is crashing, the industry wants niggas and bitches to sleep in the box while they making a mockery following us. This ain't monopoly, watch it for love. This ain't monogamy, y'all getting fucked. Jumping on what the hell is that I got?
Dude, there's a lot of fucking words going on here. Okay, there's a lot of words.
I relax when I feel. All my descendants, they come in my sleep and say I am too real. I'm done with the sensitive, taking it personal. Done with the black and the white, the wrong and the right. You hoping for change in curricles. I know the feelings that came with burial cries.
Bitch, you ugly as fuck.
You out of pocket.
Two ATMs, you step in the what?
You out of pocket.
Who you think they talk about? Talk about us.
You out of pocket.
Who you think they copy up? Copy up us.
Serving up a look, dancing in a drop. Hello to the big step, but never lose a count.
So like, see, what I like about what's going on underneath, I mean, obviously the lyrics are the most important thing. The words, it's all about the words. They're being delivered, though, with this a little more complex sensibility underneath, the colors of a major 7 chord and a minor 9 chord with fourths and ninths and all of these things going on. It's creating, there's a lot of tension in these chords. You don't just have a regular triad, 1, 1, 3, and 5. You've got that major 7, which is that tension, And you got another couple friends joining in here, so the tension alleviates, but it's still there. So you get these moments too of there's a, like an onslaught of words. He's got a lot of words, a lot of lyrics, and sometimes you're going to have some lines that slow down and it gives you a break. There's, it's not like he understands pacing.
In pools I can swim on my fate. Cameras moving whenever I'm moving. The family suing whatever I make. Murder is stacking. The president acting. The government taxing. My funds in the bank. Homies ejecting the fence when I'm breaking. Look at my reaction. My pupils on skates. Holla, holla.
Let's think about this for a second. Tell me what you would do for status. We show your show no credit. We show your bro for leverage.
What a hypocrite said. Right. What community feel they're the only ones relevant? What a hypocrite said. What community feel they're the only ones relevant?
So it really does seem like he's working out this fame that he's got, what he's done since he's come into fortune, fame, celebrity, and how it's, he's deviated from himself, and we're hearing about it. And I love this. I love the idea here. I love the concept here.
What the fuck is council culture, dog? Say what I want about you niggas, I'm like overdog. I treat you crackers like I'm jigger, watch I own it all. Oh, you worry about a critic, that ain't protocol.
Album I could just play along to and have fun with it. But I really like, I love the subject matter. And I relate to it and I connect to it. Really, it's just a man in his art form being as honest, masterful, and as open as he could possibly be. I really dig that. And we have, as a world, watched so many stars fall. And I'm seeing that this might not happen to him. Over the years, you know, like, when you get fame and fortune at that young of an age, and you are not developed and strong, something bad's going to happen. You're going to go down some way. And let's just see if he doesn't do that. It's really inspiring. So, N95. There we go. It's just N95 wasn't even mentioned. It's just the metaphor. Killer. I love it. By the way, my son Noah, who's a huge Kendrick fan, my son Zach, my oldest and my middle, they've seen Kendrick a bunch of times. They're huge fans. I haven't heard what Zach thinks about the new album, but my middle son, Noah, was like not digging it so much. So I was curious if I was going to like it when we were coming on to do this today. And guess what? I do. Hey, don't forget to like and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for notifications. And leave some comments. I'd love to hear what you think. And have a very musical day.